Let's get started with the basics on how to install MetaTrader. We're going to first select a brokerage and open a demo or a real account. The install will be the same for either. And you'll get a download file after you sign up for the demo. We have given you a list of brokers that we work with down below that we recommend that we have traded with. And the first thing to do will be to open up the download file that they give to you. It'll be a fairly quick download, and you just run it. And the first thing that you want to check is if you have other MT4 installs, especially from the same broker. This will write over if it's from the same broker. So I'll show you how to prevent that soon. Let's go ahead and download this, and I'll come right back. The latest versions of MetaTrader don't give you quite as many options, but go ahead and just follow along and install this. This is obviously XNest. They have nice low spreads, great for international traders. I let them open up all these things, and we'll just let this download here. It's not a big file. MetaTrader is extremely efficient. It can run multiple versions on one PC. Right now I'll be doing a simple install, which is a install that is portable. And on some servers and on some PCs, obviously I'm using Windows, you will get a special install that is not portable. And I'll show you what I mean by portable. All the contents are going in one folder, and I'll be able to move that folder around and execute MetaTrader forward and no matter where that folder is. Very nice way to install it. The other way is when it's not installed into one folder, it's kind of difficult to work with. Okay, they opened up. This is the MetaTrader 5 and 4 automated trading website. And this is actually, if you have a Mac or some computer that doesn't support MetaTrader particularly well, you can trade online here. They also have a market for signals here, which is interesting. This is a way that you can skip many aspects of learning to trade and just sign up with the signal service, which copies signals right to your account and keep the profits and pay about $20 a month. There's a tab once MetaTrader is installed that will bring you back to this service, and it's fairly simple to sign up. It's a great way to just automate your trading and just look for those returns. I'll do another video on how to evaluate these as far as longevity and realistic returns, but for now we've seen basics of that. That'll open up automatically. Okay, so the download has been finished and it should be opening up a version of MetaTrader right now. And the truth is that
incoming mail.
The standard templates for MetaTrader are a bit messy looking. They have a lot of grids on them. It takes just a minute. You can see down here that it's backfilling, and it'll take a few minutes for it to fill in the charts. In the meantime, you're going to have an option to open up a brokerage demo account from MetaTrader directly, or close a few of these out right now. We'll get back to these. And I don't know why I say MetaTrader 5, but let's see what we got here. Here's our main trade window down here. This, since it's a demo account, it's got 10,000 demo dollars in it. And just one second. Okay, so most of the videos that we're going to produce will be focusing on using MetaTrader 4. There's not a whole lot of difference between MetaTrader 4 and 5, but here's what's offered for MetaTrader 4 through XNest. They have the Macintosh version, Linux, Android version, which is the mobile version, very useful, which will be tied to the same account, and the MetaTrader for iOS. And what I did is I just downloaded a specific MetaTrader for EXE. It's the same install for 4 and 5. I just showed you a bit about how to do 5. 4 is exactly the same. I just wanted to stick it all with MetaTrader 4. And so we have MetaTrader 4 opened up. You'll notice it doesn't have the MT5 here. And this is the ability to open an account that pops up when you open the platform. And sometimes it won't backfill until you do open an account with them, a demo account. Some brokers will let you open an account from here. I don't think the XNest will. I think they want you to go to their website. Yeah, they want you to go to their website. So I have demo accounts. Let me put in the information and update the account, and I'll be right back. Okay, I have my account information, and especially for these big brokers, make sure that you get the right server. Some of them have many, and make sure if you're using a demo that you have the demo server. Otherwise, they'll tell you that you have the wrong or invalid account, whereas you may have a good account, but you may not have the right server. So just go ahead and press login, and you'll see that the charts will start to update, and we're running live now, so you'll see the charts actually ticking in real time. Like I said, the charts when they first come up aren't real pretty. Their default templates are not real pretty at all. I'm going to show you how to put in some nicer looking ones and some standard looking ones. I honestly go ahead in and erase all their standard ones, and I don't like their grid. One thing I'm definitely going to show you is how to get rid of a grid today, which is Control G. We'll get rid of the grid. Or we have a nice right click menu here that also gets rid of the grid. And it also has all your shortcuts here. And one that I want to remember to show you is this refresh is very useful sometimes for redrawing your indicators, especially overlay indicators. And it's helpful sometimes if you want to make sure your chart's up to date. And okay, so first thing I want to show you how to do is clean up and put in some charts and templates that you're going to use and like. This part of the video, something I'm going to refer a lot of people to as they go to our website and download special indicators, special profiles, templates, and expert advisors known as EAs. Let's do that first, and then I'll go over some of the aspects of MetaTrader and how to customize it and make it work really well for you. So first thing we're going to do is actually go into the file menu here and open data folder, and this will tell you if it installed to a portable or to a multi-folder setup. So I'm going to go ahead and open this here, and we are actually inside of the main operating folder. I see everything's in here. This was, like I said, a portable install, and not a bad practice. The first thing you do is you go ahead, you see I have many installs in here of XNest. I have many different brokers that I work with. First thing I want to do is actually rename this folder. So that if I ever do another XNest install, oh, it actually won't let me rename it right now because it's open, but that's how you rename it. After you close the main platform, and let you rename that. So if you ever do another install, it won't write over your main MetaTrader install. And you can run multiple versions of this. I can open up any of these at the same time, and my computer has no problem running 4, 5, or 6 MetaTraders at a time. It's a great program as far as efficiency. And if I ever want to make a specific shortcut for this, I just go ahead and right-click and on the terminal exe here, right-click, create shortcut, and I want to rename the shortcut to MetaTrader Training. Right-click on it again and rename it, and this will be XNest. Go. And then I can put that on the desktop as a shortcut if I want to run multiple MetaTraders. The reasons for running multiple MetaTraders is sometimes I like to use one specifically for backtesting. One, I like to have a lot of charts backfilled on so I can look back through historical charts and test out systems. Sometimes I like to have different platforms running different trading systems. Some I like to run automated and some I like to run manual. As a beginner, one is more than enough to learn on, but I wanted to show you, this is the home base here, and inside this folder is how we're going to be doing installing all of these quick setups for having MetaTrader look nice and run well, and pretty much your plug and play capacity. So, minimize this so you can pay attention here, and let's say you went to the website and you downloaded a few files from the website. For instance, with this video will be a link to download these learning templates and profiles from our main website, this link below, and I'll just teach you how to fill in what you get. So first thing will be a profile. I'm going to just copy the profile here. Here's our profiles. Paste it in there. And you can actually, it's up to you when you want to close Metatrader 4, but we are going to close it. And it doesn't matter if it's open while you're doing this. This is actually a EA that I'm going to show you how to use, which is nice to learn how to install those. We'll go back to the main subdirectory here, the Exynos directory. This MQL4, this is where it holds the indicators and the expert. Experts are also known as expert advisors or EAs or robots. So next thing we have here is actually a robot. And the way I can tell is that it's got an MQ4 behind it, but unfortunately in Metatrader, they didn't make any difference between the MQ4s for indicators or MQ4s for experts. You kind of have to keep track of it, and you can rename them if you need to, or just copy and paste them in bulk. But this I know is an expert, and it goes in the experts folder. And they won't run in the wrong folder, so if you can't get it to run, try another folder. But on the website, they'll tell you what they are. And this just gives you a lot of pre-setup power. Okay, so this is a template. I should use the indicator. Set the indicator into the indicators. Copy and paste this in the indicators. These are the default indicators that Metatrader gives to you. Very basic, nice indicators that are very commonly used, and show you how to select those and play with those. Next thing is going to be, let's go back and put in that template. So the templates are actually on the main directory. Templates right here. And templates. Okay. These are the four main categories of basically plugins. Oftentimes you'll just be picking up a free indicator. You'll get really used to this if you like to experiment and learn new things. So it's really simple. You've got your profiles, profiles and your templates on your main directory. In MQL4, you've got your experts and your indicators. Experts are your EAs, expert advisors, and also known as robots. And after that, you're all set to reopen that. And just because I have so many Metatraders, I'm just going to go ahead and launch from the main directory here. I've got that shortcut and all that set up here, but it's the terminal exe. It's fine to launch from. Obviously, they'll put one on your desktop, but if you have multiple Metatraders, you have to set up your shortcuts so you can keep them straight. You can see on my desktop here, I have many different installs. I'm actually hiding a lot of them right now. Here's the new one that probably went in. But in my normal desktop, you can't see them here, but I have many different shortcuts to MT4. This is not necessary. It's just something that I do as a developer and a programmer. This learning this one instance will be plenty for you. Okay, so this is where it pays off, learning those four different folders there that I just showed you. We're going to switch profiles, and we're going to switch this learning profile that we just installed. Obviously, I have to restart Metatrader to enable all the things we just basically plugged in. And here's the learning profile, and it's much prettier. And what we're seeing here, get this out of the way for now. What we're seeing here is the up bars. These are candlestick bars. This is how you select candlesticks. And your candlestick bars are green for the up bars and are red for the down bars. And it's just looks more like a normal trading platform at this time. Also, here's my trade availability. I've got $100,300 in or something in here. And here's a simple indicator, stochastic, that's nicely colored. And these are actually bars that these divisors here are showing me per day. So it's the 9th and the 10th. It's separating each day so I can get an idea. These are 30-minute bars. I think I'll change these down to 5-minute bars. And obviously you can select whatever you want, 5-minute, 1 hour. Okay, so to get rid of these day separators, because if you zoom back on a chart, you right-click and go into Properties. And you can change the colors of your layout. And you can also change a lot of different settings here, but this is the period separators here. A lot of times I like to show the ask line, which will allow me to do that there. It shows me the bid and the ask line together. These I'm not going to play with too much, but these are the auto scroll and shift the chart to the end of the chart, and I just press OK, and that got rid of those period separators. Now let's see why this isn't changing to a change in time frames. Well, the good news is I can show you how to open up a new chart here, and we will go for, I'll show you the other way to open up. This is one way to open up a new chart. If they're making it difficult for you with a big list like this, it's actually an easier way to do it. We can go into the market watch, and we can find, for instance, the euro US dollars here, right click and chart window, and you can see it's a total mess. Again, I've got my grid back on there, and this way your template comes in. And your template, we go to the one that we learned, learning template, and there it is again. I'd saved the profile as a template also, and I had this set up on there. This was something I wrote. Obviously, I made this profile and this template from another MetaTrader, so it's just like if you downloaded from the website. Now I can easily change time frames to a 5 minute or back up to a 30 minute. And to tell you the truth, I'm not sure why this one won't change time frames, but I'm just going to close that one. Gives me an opportunity to show you different things. We have this nice spread. This is the bid and the ask, or the buy and the sell. This is the difference between the buy and the sell price. And this is the amount that you'd be buying and selling at. This, I don't use this very often, but this is like a quick press. If you press this, it'll enter a large order. In fact, we'll just set this down a little bit to 0.1. Be about, oh wow. Okay, there we go. And you can buy and sell from right here. I just don't use this very often. Okay, so if I want to buy, I can buy the euro US dollar. They're asking me to agree to this method of trading. It's called one-click trading, and this enables a bunch of aspects of MT4 that are really useful. I'm going to accept that and say okay. I'm going to buy again, and there we go. This is the euros. Okay, now you see this K at the end. Some of these accounts, because this is a demo account, some brokers have something after the euro, US dollar, like an M or a K or whatever they decide. This distinguishes their accounts, and I'll show you a little bit more about that in a minute. Okay, well, you can see we've actually made a few dollars on our trade here. A couple ways to close out a trade. Obviously, you can have a couple options. You can set a take profit here. You just click and drag on that line, and you can see once that line goes into place, if you mouse over that line, you can see the profit is at $33, 330, well, it's actually 33 pips, 33.8 pips is actually what the profit gain is on that. And you can see when I drag that over here, it's actually keeping track of what your profit will be. And that includes the spread and everything. You can see it's $21, and then $30, and then $43, $44. So you can set that down and then mouse over it again, and that's how easy it is to give a take profit and a stop loss and to check what your profit would be on that. Obviously, if you want to be able to set a stop loss, you just click and drag. Since we have a buy here, you drag the stop loss down. As you can see, we're minus $26 here. And that's 24.4 pips. One thing about MetaTrader, they do it in points, and points are different than pips. This is 238 points, which is 23.8 pips. It's something to get used to with Forex. You've got some long numbers. But simply, the nice thing is it tells you how much your profit and loss is in dollars, and you'll get used to the pips. In fact, since we're on the subject of pips, if I wanted to check and see how many pips are involved, there's a great way to do that. And that way is I can just click on the center roller. So I'm pressing on the center mouse roller, the roller ball in the middle, and that gives me these crosshairs. And I actually think there's another way to do it too. If you set your crosshairs, you can grab your crosshairs up here. Grab your crosshairs, and then you left click and drag. And that is giving me how many pips. So this is says 300, which is the second number there. And that's actually 30.0 pips. And you get used to that. And some platforms are slightly different. If they're four-digit platforms, this is actually a five-digit platform, which means that there's five zeros, actually five digits after the decimal point here, and this is the euro, US dollar on this day. But in general, simply, we'll teach you a little bit more about what pips mean and these take profits and all. This is really a setup video, but nice way to grab your crosshairs and drag, and it'll give you the distance. The third number there is the price, and that first number is how many bars. You can see it's counting as I move it horizontally to the right. That first number is counting how many bars since my crosshairs. Nice thing to get used to that you use more, especially for the overlays. Okay, so that's enough of that. Let's say I want to close out here with a profit immediately. I can press this X here. I can select the trade and right click and close order. And I can also modify and delete order here. I can set up trailing stop. And I can switch the profit reading here. And okay, so I'm just going to close the order for now. There we go. And now that'll show up in my account history tab here. And here's my profit. I made $4.90. And there's some really nice ways to be able to produce reports from this. If I save this as a detailed report, it will actually give me a nice HTML web page style printout with all my trades and graphs and statistics about my trading. It's a really nice thing to use. So that's from the account history tab. And also, obviously I can save it as, I can set custom periods. So if I want to check for last month, how's my trading been? I can create a graph and a chart and a whole bunch of statistics about it. You know, my average trades in a row that won and lost. So really nice aspect of Metatrader for sharing your trades. Also, I can, if I want to check that trade, what happened in the last trade, I can actually click and drag this, pull it up my chart here, and it will, since I made a quick trade, I'm on the 30-minute bars here. Let me move down to the 5-minute bars. And this is, I'm going to click and drag on this, and this will change my scale of my chart. And you can see this is where I entered the trade with the blue arrow here. This is where I exited the trade with the red arrow. And this was the distance that the trade traveled. And it should have some information on it here. You can see I bought at one price and closed at another price. And here's the profit here. So any of your trades you can pull up onto a chart from this account history. The other thing that you can do with these charts is, if you want to switch the chart, instead of making a new one, go back into the market watch here. Let's say I want to trade this, change this chart to the Euro Japanese Yen. Just click it and drag it in the chart, and the template will stay the same, but now this is the Euro Japanese Yen 5-minute. And something to realize is that if I want to check that Euro US dollar trade and I don't put it on the right chart, it'll switch me back to the Euro US dollar chart, so be careful about that. You can see the switch back to the Euro US dollar again. Another interesting aspect to Metatrader is that when you want to move something or change something, oftentimes they'll ask you to double click on it. For instance, I can move this now, but I just double clicked on it and now I can't move it. So this is technique of double clicking quickly to move anything in the chart is used for a lot of the drawing tools. And I have some special indicators that have the profit loss print out up here, and you can move that anywhere you want and fix it there. That's especially helpful if you draw a horizontal line on the chart. You can't move that line until you double click on it, and then you can move it. And if I want to leave it there or set it there, I double click it on, double click quickly, and that will freeze the line in that place. Also, if you feel like there's just too many symbols here, you can try to right click and to hide symbols. Hide all is what it's called. Like it is a euro, US dollar. Let's just hide some. How's that? Well, didn't like that, did it? Let's show off for a minute. A lot of times if you want to find out how many currencies are available and if they have any metals or indexes available, here I have some commodities, is heating oil and crude light. And, I actually trade a lot of these. These are really useful sometimes. I right-clicked and I showed all. Then I had a massive list. And I'm going to have, if I want to hide some, this will limit the list down a little bit, but it's still a big list. If I just want to select certain ones, I can hide the hide all. Anyways, there's different settings there. For now, I'm just going to leave that as a show all. Anyways, this is your list of buy and sells, and there's actually a useful thing here to be able to show your spread. If you select that, it'll show the spread. This is spread in points. That's actually 1.7 pips, 1.6 pips. This early in the morning. Use this XNES count. We'll go down to 1.0 or 1 pip, 0.9 pips. They have really good pips, but this is early morning. That is your market watch. It is useful for setting up new charts. So if I want to open up a US dollar Swiss franc, I just put a new chart. That is chart window. It'll backfill, put a template on it. And once the template's on there, let me show you how to change a template. Let's say I want to get rid of those separators again. Go in, take away the show period separators. They're gone now. And I can just go in and save that template the way I want it. And this is my learning template. I double clicked on it, said yes, or I could have just said save. And now, if I open up a new chart, it won't have those. In fact, I can put it in the other chart. Here's the Euro US dollar. When I apply the template, it's going to get rid of this, any additions. It's going to go back to default, but it will, so it means it'll get rid of this horizontal line. But it will get rid of the period separators because I've changed that in the template. So learning template, there we go. And if I wanted to change the profile, I could actually rename the profile here. Save profile as new profile. Okay, and then I can switch back and forth. If I close out this chart and I want it open back again and go back to the learning profile, and that will be set up as before. So your templates and your profiles you can use to save your details, and you can make as many as you want, and you can set them basically as return to default, and you can save just about everything. Okay, the profiles will save multiple charts. The templates are just to put on one chart at a time, and obviously you see we have many of them here. We have some ugly ones from Metatrader. This is the original ugly ones from Metatrader. And like I said, you can delete these by remove template, Bollinger Bands, and it's gone. Or you can do it from the base directory there. We'll just go back to our nice template here. Okay, this is the basics of how to get set up. Let me show you how to put a indicator on there. Then insert indicators, and we'll put a moving average on there. This allows me to select what kind of moving average I'm going to put on there. You may not understand what these mean, but a common moving average is an exponential moving average. It's often applied to the median price, which means the high low divided by 2. You can choose your color here and your thickness here. I like to make, when you can, if it's a single thickness, you can choose these dotted displays, or I like to add a little thickness. I press OK, and this is a moving average. It's averaging the last 50 bars. Teach you a lot more about how all these things work later, but for now, that's basically how you set them up and add them to the chart. Okay. There is another way to install your indicators and your robots, and let me show you from the navigator here. We can see all the indicators that we installed, and I actually had installed this MACD color install. This is an indicator that we custom installed at setup, and I'm going to okay, here we go. The easy way to do that is just click and drag it on the chart, and I have our inputs here, and this is kind of a technical indicator. It just looks nice, and you can also set your levels. These are your levels here. Here's your levels. Right now we have a level on this other one at 80 and 20, and I can add those if I want to. Right now I'm just going to set one at 0, and I'll change the color of that. Okay, so set that there, and this indicator is been applied. If I wanted to put an expert advisor on there, I'd just do the same thing. I would drag it on the chart. It would give me my comments. I want to allow live trading. Some of these expert advisors, you have to have DLL imports allowed. And then here's my settings. This is just a default sample one that they give to you. And that's what it takes to put an expert advisor on there. You can see that the smiley face is down. It means it's not ready to auto trade. These expert advisors, they'll actually do the entire trade for you. They'll open the trade, close the trade, watch the market, put the money in your account, and wait for the next trade. There's a lot to learn about them, but you have to enable auto trading here, and you can see it turned to smiley, and therefore you're actually ready to trade. And it's actually live and trading. And if this is a real account, I would want to be much more thoughtful about the setup and what I was using, but this is actually running and trading. If I let this run, it would open and close trades, and I can check what size trades, the properties of the what size trade. I think that's F7 for that. Let me check real quickly here. Expert advisors. Yeah, F7 is a shortcut to check what's happening. The lot size would be 0.01, so on this currency, be near a dollar a pip. And I've got trailing stop. I'm not going to teach about these too much right now. Let's just go ahead and remove that. And that's how you remove them. Let's show you how to get rid of things. I'm going to just double click on that and delete it. If I don't want this indicator, I can right click and delete the indicator window. And let's say I want to take a look at the chart, the history of the chart. Close this out for now so it's not in the way. And actually, this is the terminal, and there's a couple ways to make the terminal bigger, smaller. This little bar here, I double clicked on it, but I just like to get out of the way. I mentioned to you there's a way to find the signals here. This is the signal services, and this will populate. This is much like the website that opened up when we first installed, and it offers different signals. You can, I think when you click on these, some of these are actually free, you can test them out. This is a subscription window that they take you to on the website. You learn how to enable them and sign up. I'm not going to go through that now, but that's available through the terminal, like I said. And let's say that you want to take a look at the chart and move the chart around. So I'm just left-clicking and dragging on the chart. Another way that's really good to know is to turn the center wheel on the mouse, and that will turn the chart. This is your zoom, zoom back, zoom forward. Yeah, if you want to zoom, there's a shortcut for the zoom too. It's your, there's a couple ways to zoom, but this is the easiest way here. Yeah, you can use your plus and minus symbols also on some PCs sometimes. It's actually not working all the time, but easiest way is here, zooming in and out. Then kind of keep track of how many times you pressed it for a standardized zoom. It does make a difference how you watch charts. Like the slope of this trend looks very different. If I zoom out, it makes the trends look much different. You notice every time I try to move this chart, it keeps snapping back to the same place. If you ever want to look back on your chart and not have it snap back every time it clicks, you look for this green arrow, and that will disable that. You use the green arrow to keep your charts up to speed. I just minimize this window, and if I want to watch my charts like this side by side, and I want them to keep up, I just press that green arrow, and every time a new price ticks, it'll keep me right in the correct place. And this is my indent mark, my tab kind of mark. So for now, I'm gonna disable that scrolling. It's called auto scrolling, and using the center wheel of my mouse, I can catch a little bit of history on the chart. It's actually not much history on this chart, and if I want to add some history, it's the history center here, and I go into the 4X, I think this is 4X mini, for example. Actually, these are the M's. I have to find the K's, which I think, I don't even know. This is a demo account. Here they are, the K's, so I'd find the Euro, US dollar. Oh, actually, these are M's, sorry. We go into the 4X mini. That's why that first chart wouldn't work, is actually a K, that 30-minute one switch. Okay, so I go to the Euro, US dollar, 1 minute, and this should be in alphabetical order. Double-click on that. Oh, and here's the 1 minute. Just push download. I'm not going to do this because this takes a couple minutes. If I press download, this will give me a whole bunch more history that I can look back in the charts and check my different strategies historically. There's ways to import data for entire years. We'll teach you more about that later, but that's the history center. Okay, so if I want to add drawings, these are arrows I can add. We have our Fibonacci tool here. This is a channel, like an equidistant channel that I can draw. Like I said, once I've dropped that there, I can't move it unless I double-click on it, and then I can move it again, and I can adjust it like that. There's one thing I want to show you how to set up, which is, I'm going to delete that. I right-clicked and delete, is how to set up a Fibonacci tool. You may well not know what a Fibonacci tool is, but you can see that. There we go. It's over here. It's that one where you can watch it here. Okay. Fibonacci's are special numbers that people use to gauge trends. And these are special numbers, but if you don't like these numbers, and I often use different numbers, I double-clicked on it, and then I right-clicked. I'm going to check the properties. And in this parameters here, fib levels, you can actually stretch all these windows, I believe. Can I? No, they won't let me stretch this. A lot of windows you can stretch. Anyways, let's say I want to set this to 25, the 25 level. This would be 0.25. And I can set those all according to how I want. But this is how you set some of the parameters. So now I have 25 instead of 23 point whatever, which is the original fib number. I could have added and gotten rid of some of these and added the 1.25 extension. That's just the general way that you change some of the settings on there. These arrow. Okay, so we'll show you how to add text, and this is how you. And I like to put this in white, and I like to make the size bigger, and this will give me. Okay, so that gives me one of these little. Let's say I wanted to designate this as my, trade, enter late. Sometimes I put notes on my charts and stuff like that. That's what it is. And if I want to get rid of that, I'm just gonna right click and delete it. While it's selected. Okay, I'm going to delete the Fibonacci. It's already right-clicked. And I believe that you can hide this window. I don't use it. So I actually have nice indicators that I'll be giving to people that show the spread in real-time digital and show your profit loss on the screen. So I don't need those windows. Those will be at the website. And let's show you how to. If you have a lot of data after you backfilled, I'll delete this also. If you have a lot of data after you backfill, you can move quickly through the chart, page up and page down. Sometimes you have to enable your number lock. We'll actually scroll you really quickly. Right now there's not much data on here, but you can press those and they'll move you left or right on the screen. Also, if you're surveying a lot of data, it's good to zoom back so you can watch. And if you're scrolling, and you hold the crosshairs on there, I just press the center wheel, click the center wheel. It'll keep track of the date, so that actually gives you the year. You can see down here, you have the year and the month. So sometimes you're scrolling through different years, and you won't be able to see that unless you have the center crosshairs enabled. This is going to be useful. What I'm about to show you is going to be useful for a lot of people. This will be useful for backtesting expert advisors, and it'll also be very useful for checking indicators in real time. It's almost like fake trading, and there's actually nice downloads that we'll show you later on how to actually fake trade with accelerated time speed, meaning like you can make trades based on historical data running quickly. So let me show you how to do that really quickly. The EA that we installed, we're going to show you how to use that with what I'm about to show you. So Strategy Tester's here. It's got the magnifying glass on it, and Control R is a shortcut for that. And this is your backtesting station. Though it looks simple, it's actually an amazing free tool that they give you with MetaTrader. I'm going to show you in just a couple minutes quickly how to run this, even for basic traders, as a real advantage. Okay, so we'll try to change this down to 5-minute bars. The spread, I like to keep it at 2. If you are on the weekends or something like that, you'll have massive spreads. So I'll leave this by default to 2. It could be a little bit bigger if your broker runs really big spreads, but 2 is good for most of the time. Right now, I'm going to use the Euro-US dollar, and you can see it's on the 5-minute, and I'm going to choose the expert. And for a normal trading expert advisor, if let's just say I had this sample one that they put in there, I would normally use a date. And if I was going to use a date, I could choose today's date and then go back a week from today's date or whatever. But I'm not sure I have so much data in the system right now, so I'm just going to turn off the use date, and it'll just use the data that I have available. And let's say I'm going to run this moving average. I'm going to run it on visual mode. And I actually have to expand my window to even see visual mode here, which is a very important thing to realize. Here's visual mode. And this is the back play on the visual mode. So I'm just going to start this. And they're going to throw me up a grid as soon as this fills. You can see it's collecting data right now. Okay, so you can see it's got the grid. I've got rid of the grid by right-clicking there. And it right away it entered a trade. You can see the 2nd of February is the first day that I've got date here, got data. And it's actually in a trade right now. You can see from the tester, it's got the trade open. I'm in a buy at 0.2. And I'm going to accelerate that. That's the beautiful thing about this back tester. And once you get up to these high numbers, it starts to trade really fast, move way too fast. You can set this, I think you can use your up and down arrows for those to get real specific numbers. But once you get too high, your down arrow brings it up in speed. But these are all trades. This is, I think the blue is a buy, the red's a sell. It's keeping track of all your profits and losses. This one's actually making a bit of money. It's up $100, and it was up almost $200 at one point. Here's all the trades that it made. Okay, so that is a simple way to use this. There's obviously, and in the end, you can stop it, and it'll generate you a report. This report's a lot like I told you can get from your account history. And you can write-port this and export it as HTML that you can attach to an email. It's going to have a graph on it and everything, and it's showing you all kinds of consecutive trades and wins and losses and total profit and maximum drawdown. Okay, so keeping this simple, what I wanted to show you for a simple trader, once you've designed a system or learned a system and you want to take a look at it with moving bars, but you don't want to sit there for days and days just watching it tick, tick, tick. You can use historical data even from another year. We'll show you how to set up that all up. But the EA that we installed is called the Blank Tester. And this is one that I just made up. It's not a very complex EA. And what it does is it enters no trades, but it lets the back tester run as fast as you want to run. So let's go ahead and press start. And we don't want the speed too fast. I want to be able to set this up. And actually you can pause this even, but we'll start it. Still in visual mode. I'm going to get rid of the grid. They give you the grid every time. It's kind of annoying. And there are programs where I can open and close trades and they'll keep track of it. But for now, I'm just going to show you the simple version of it. And that's a free program, something we'll link you up to at another time after we teach you how to use it. But for now, you have a running chart that are real historical bars. This we chose 5 minutes. We could have chosen 1 hour or 30 minutes. And we have the ability to actually put indicators on here now. So close out our expert advisors, open up the indicators. We'll go ahead and put the MACD color alert on here. Just leave it all default, press OK. And now I can watch this indicator form up in real time, so I can see at what, how much the bars are changing, if the price is changing quickly. Let's say I had a strategy that I wanted to be long, meaning make a buy trade and hold it until this thing changes colors. I can watch it in real time and see how I would have done or when I would have had to exit. Obviously not a brilliant strategy, but a strategy. Just an example. But if I take off this screen scroll, I can go back and look at it. And then obviously if I want it just to show the most current time, I've got it right there. And I can add all the indicators on here. I can add lines on, horizontal lines on here. I can add any of the text or the arrows. And I can imagine, okay, I would have gone, it just changed color. Now that it's a down colors, I wanted to start going short. And how would this have looked in real time? That's just an example. How to use this backtester as a, and if I want to speed up the speed, this doesn't do real well speeding up the speed because it goes from slow to really fast, but you can skip ahead, basically, is what you can do. And it'll run, depending on how many indicators you have on there and how complex they are, it'll run a little bit slower, a little bit faster. But this is a very useful way to test your back tests. And like I said, we'll give you access to the EA that will let you buy and sell and keep track of all your profits and losses in accelerated time. Just want to show you that. And so if you want to stop that and close it out, and these visuals will stay up there. If you restart the program, a lot of times these visual program, these visual tabs will actually disappear. So if you want to save these tabs, like you had a bunch of buys and sells on there that you wanted to save, you actually have to save that as a template so that you can put it on a regular chart. But usually I just close those out, because they look just like normal historical charts. This is you can take a look at how this thing traded. This was that MACD sample. It's just a free one. There's lots and lots of free EAs out there, and most of them aren't that good, but this one's kind of interesting. It was this is the moving average that it was based on, but it's just really the this backtester is a bit like an oracle. It will show you and teach you so many things about what you're trying to do and what your strategies are. It's amazing they were able to give it for free and make it standard application. And we'll teach you how to tick test and really get some EAs to actually make you money. Also, you can apply templates to your strategy tester. When you open up a chart with that blank EA, you can put a template right on there and get started with your strategy, watching it in accelerated time. To finish up the basics here, we covered most of the buttons up here. Obviously, if you want to place a new order, you can open up the order here, and you decide if you want to go buy or sell. You can set your stop loss and take profit ahead of time. You can also enter a pending order, and we'll teach you how to decide if you want to buy limit, buy stop, sell stops, etc., and how to place these at another time. This is your price that you want to place it at, and it's going to be sensitive to whether, what kind of order you're placing, whether it'll be above or below the bid and ask. And you can set your stop loss and take profit here, and you can change the what you're using. And be very careful about your volume here, what size you want to use. You put in too much, you'll have a big problem. And you just place it. I'll just go ahead and place an order here, a regular market orders, because it's be easier for everybody to follow. So I'm going to sell at the market this time, 0.04. This would be about 40 cents per pip for the euro US dollar. And some platforms have a limit on how big or how small an order can be. And it may reject your orders if you're trying to place too much of an order, or if you're trying to use too big of an order for your account size. That is, you don't have enough margin. We'll go over all that later. And here's the order here. It's in place, so I can just close it out like that. And it's showing up in my account history now as two orders. Okay. This is how you switch your chart style. Okay, we're already in open high, low close. It's the OLHC, which is these bars. The tick on the left is the open, and the tick on the right is the close. We want to switch to a line chart, which is very soft and kind of, it's not the most precise chart for sure, if I want to switch to candlestick. And as you see, this was the visual. If I put a template on that, I have to put the template on before I start the trading, because if I put a template on there now, it's going to take away all these trades. So let's put on that learning template. It'll give us nice candlesticks, but it took away all the trades and it set us back to default. So it's something to be aware of. We'll get rid of that. And it's still a visual chart, so I'm going to close it out because it's going to disappear later. Last thing I want to show you is not something most people use, but it is actually a good tool for people who are setting up a lot of charts. This is the language editor. And what this means is that you have, this is where the coding happens. And I'm not going to make a big deal out of this because it's above most people's ability. But let's say we go into the indicators here and we want to, here's our basic indicators. And let's say, remember we use the moving average, so let me find it real quickly here. They put it under something like bands or something like that. Here's a custom moving average. See if this one will work for us. Open. Okay, so you can see we have, and there's, you know, there's another way to open these, much simpler. If you want to modify something, and you can right click on it, say I want to modify my CC, modify it, and that'll open up in this editor. And here's the CCI. Anyways, let's say we have a basic moving average here. And the only reason I'm showing you this at this time is just to make you aware of what this is. And let's say the default on the platform that you always use is, let's say you like a 250 moving average. And every time you put on this indicator, these basic indicators will actually oftentimes save your default. But on the other indicators, any custom indicators, every time you put on the chart, you'll have to reset all the settings or pull up a set file. But if you want to just change the default moving average period, and let's say you like the shift to 1 or you like a different kind of moving average method, I'll use this as an example. This can be a little bit more complicated than necessary. But if I press F1, oh, I have to download the help menu. Maybe I won't do that too much. But anyways, the help menu will pop up, and it'll tell me how I can switch this default mode. And here it is. It didn't take too long. I can change this. Let's say I normally like a moving average. I can copy that. This is my exponential moving average as a default. And I can put that in there as a paste it in there. Okay. And still got the... these all have to have semicolons after them. It's still here. It just moved down one line. Notice that right away. And then you can see it's got a star next to it. And then I compile it. It says no errors. That's fine. So now when I open that up, let's see if it actually worked. This is strange how this is working, because it's telling me it's an MQL5 editor, which is almost like a Metatrader 5 editor while we're in a Metatrader 4 here. But the truth is, for the code, it doesn't make that much difference. They're on the same code, so it's just Metatrader. They do weird things, and they update the platform, and things change. So let's see if that actually worked. So I don't even see the move. I can put it in this way if I want to. Insert, indicators, trend, moving average. Didn't take it. It was supposed to set that to default. On any of these custom ones like this one, you can change the defaults, and it'll change them. I actually think that was two different indicators that I changed there. One was custom and one was a moving average or something. But anyhow, that's how it works. Every time you put on any of your custom indicators, say one that you download from the website, if you want to change the defaults, that's exactly how you do it. You modify it. Now you have your default inputs. If you want to change any of them, like your fast EMA, you can change that to different default. Let's go ahead and do it here. We'll change it from 12 to 20. And we'll compile it. And now when I open this up, the default is now 20. So I don't have to reset that every time. It's just a handy tool. And that also shows you where all the custom developments done for the program, and you can learn a lot here too, but it's not really for beginners. Just wanted to show you that aspect. It is very helpful when you're putting on a lot of indicators. Also, your template will save the settings for these custom indicators and all your indicators on the chart, and your profile will also save all of them for all the charts. But once you change your profile, it's changed the profile. There's no going back to default. You have to start a new one if you want to make changes and go back to the old one. All right, so for now, I think that's a really good introduction to how to set up, optimize, and run Metatrader. We will have a lot of follow-up videos, and check out our website below. We'll give you all the tools you need to get started there and a couple recommended brokers. Thanks for now. We'll catch up with you next time.